Welcome to Weekly Digest, where we highlight the works of ministers of government as they push the administration's development agenda. 30 persons in Sierra Johanna were left homeless after the owner of a private land on which they were squatting demolished the structures. On Friday, the demolition began and ended on Saturday. Regardless of the squatting situation, minister within the office of the Prime Minister with responsibility for public affairs, Kwame McCoy, visited them and listened to their complaints. And the residents are happy to have some comfort from government.
Now, there are some people who would have already been part of the process of activating their application through the Ministry of Housing and Water for a land. We will continue that process as of now to get you your lands as quickly as possible.
Key development works in the Parfait Harmony Region 3 has caused 14 persons to lose income as they were forced to close their small businesses. Understanding the needs of the proprietors, government has compensated them $2.5 million. The checks were presented by Minister of Housing and Water, Colin Kroll, and Susan Rodrigues. Minister Rodrigues says the beneficiaries will also receive business management training from the Small Business Bureau and the Guyana Revenue Authority.
There's so much that I'm sure you will learn from the different training in financial management and business management and taxation, and the knowledge you will receive from that will be much, much more valuable than the check.
From August 8 to 11, the National Stadium will come alive as Guyana hosts the 2024 edition of International Building Expo. And business owners are flocking, having already purchased almost 85% of the booths. Minister of Housing and Water Colin Kroll is satisfied with the progress.
That means it's only 15% left, and some of that 15% would be the food court area. So it means that the serious side of business, by and large, has been allocated. Overall, we're looking about 341 spaces or booths for persons to occupy or to be made available.
25 technical persons in the Ministry of Natural Resources are undergoing training about oil in the face of climate change. The overseas seminar on oil development in Guyana opened on Monday at the Guyana Forestry Commission. The Natural Resources Ministry, Chinese Embassy, Sinuk, Guyana, and the Development and Research Center of China Geological Services are collaborating to make this happen. It will run from July 8 to 28.
One of the main tasks was to ensure that we build capacity. Build capacity, especially with regards to the management and regulating the oil and gas sector. It was critical that we build capacity and build it fast, because oil and gas is new to all of us, and at the pace at which the oil and gas sector is developing, it was essential that we develop our human resources at the same time too.
Minister of Parliamentary Affairs and Governance, Gail Teixeira, has re-emphasized that public servants must be accountable. She was speaking at the opening of the roundtable discussion on ethical behavior within the public service at the Pegasus Hotel in Kingston, Georgetown. The discussion focused on how to develop capacity and provide training for elective public servants to deter corruption.
When we're handling the people's money and the people's programs, we have a moral obligation to do it the right way, the best way, and to make sure that people get value for money.
50 persons will benefit from the second heavy-duty equipment operation program sponsored by the Board of Industrial Training, BIT. During the launch on Tuesday, Minister of Labor Joseph Hamilton emphasized the role of the program in upskilling Guyanese and urged those participating to absorb all the knowledge.
All of us, we have a responsibility to do as much as we can to develop ourselves, to utilize the facilities that are made available to you. And this, in this instance, the facilities all around is free.
traffic management will receive a significant boost with the passage of the amended Motor Vehicles and Road Traffic Act on Monday evening in the National Assembly. The amendments bring the utilization of 24-hour surveillance cameras on major roadways into law.
Noted generally, and I think admitted on all sides, the growth and development of our country. Along with this growth and development of our country, along with the investment in roads, along with the increase in vehicles on the road, we still struggle with road traffic accidents and deaths.
The National Assembly on Monday passed a comprehensive bill to abolish preliminary inquiries, replacing it with paper committals. This means the written evidence and arguments of the prosecution and the defense will be reviewed rather than conducting an oral in-person hearing. It will save judicial time and reduce the backlog of criminal cases.
Oral preliminary inquiries, however short they may have been intended to be, today takes about an average of 3 to 4 years minimum to be completed. So if a person is not on bail, that person is remanded to prison for this period. This is one of the main reasons for overcrowding in the prison system of our country.
In a significant move to improve the infrastructure of South Georgetown, government has announced a massive developmental project worth nearly $200 million. This investment will upgrade critical roads in Rasville and Roxanne Burnham Gardens, says Minister of Public Works, Bishop Juan Edgell.
And within the next 10 days, the Ministry of Public Works Special Programs Unit, which is headed by this gentleman here, Mr. Colin Gittens, will be fully mobilized and the entire network of Rasville roads will be done over and all the roads in Roxanne Burnham Gardens will be done over.
Minister Edgell, accompanied by Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation, UTOD, stressed the government's commitment to developing these communities.
That is why our primary role is to ensure that the human development of this country is a priority for us. We will continue to do that. We enjoy doing that. Let us continue to work together in unity, in harmony, with respect and love.
This has brought us to the end of this edition of Weekly Digest. For these and other government-related stories, do log on to our website at dpi.gov.gy and our social media platforms as well. Goodbye.